Hey everybody, this is Doug. In this video, I want to talk to you about using the left rail over here to build freeform tables in Analysis Workspace. So if you create a new blank project, you'll be presented with this screen so that you can choose what kind of panel you want to start with. And I'm just going to select freeform table. After that, you can get more freeform tables by going to the visualizations on the very left-hand side here, and then dragging in freeform tables to your project. So now I've got a couple of them. Now, when we talk about this left rail and everything over here, I kind of think it's broken into maybe three kinds of things you're going to do regarding freeform tables. And that is to find stuff that you want to put into your freeform table. That's number one. Number two is if you can't find the stuff because you don't have it, then it is create stuff so that you can put it into your freeform table. And then the third part, putting it in or adding it to your freeform table. So those are the kinds of things that we can do over here on this left-hand side. So the first thing you'll probably notice is that we have dimensions, metrics, segments, and date ranges, and that there are five items under each one. And these are actually the top five for you as a user. And so you can quickly reuse things that you have been using a lot just by going to that section and then dragging it over to your table. That being said, let's say that you're looking for a dimension that is not in those top five. Now, if you don't know exactly what it's called, so you can't really do a search on it, you just kind of want to browse what dimensions are available to you. You can either click on the word dimensions or click on show all. It does the same thing and it will give you a giant list of all your dimensions. Again, it'll, you know, depend on how many you have as to how giant this list is. In this report suite, it's pretty long. And so you could go through this and add those things that you want to your table. You can also search this specific list by going up to this search. Now it's because we have dimensions here that we will only be searching those dimensions. So I can type in product, for example. You can see I still have a lot of them in here and I can drag over product, or I have product name, or all these other product-based dimensions. Now, if I want to search more than just my dimensions, I can also just remove this dimensions label here. And now I have product across all of those. So in other words, let me get rid of that. If I have everything showing here and search on product, then I'm going to get dimensions and metrics and segments and, you know, potentially any date range that has product in it. And now you can see that I have different kinds of stuff here because the orange is dimensions and the green is metrics. And if I scroll down, I'll even see a blue one, which is a segment. And if I want to see what these are, you can see that I have a little info bubble here for this segment. And I can see that this is product views exist, and then cart additions does not exist, etc. So you can see how that works. Now, if I scroll up, I can also see what is in these dimensions by clicking on this right arrow. So if I'm not really sure if I want product or product name or something else like that, I can just take a quick look by clicking on this arrow. This shows me the items in product. And I'm looking at this and it's just kind of more of a product ID. So that's not really what I want. I'm going to click this back arrow and let's try product name. And that is really more of what I want. So I can actually go back and add product name simply by dragging it over here to the right. In any case, that's kind of the finding business over here, right? You're going to find by browsing or you're going to find by searching. So let me get rid of that again. And once again, we have all four of those types of data over here that you can do the same thing in. You can show all segments by clicking on segments or show all. I'll click on segments this time. We get all of the segments. We can search just the segments. We can go back out of segments. We can search everything. You can do the same thing with metrics. Look at all the metrics. Search for metrics. Show all of them, etc. And again, remember that I can click on the little info bubbles and get more information about all these different items, the dimensions, the metrics, etc. In the metrics one, you can see that I can get a trend line for unique visitors. Anyway, hopefully that helps for the finding section. Now, what about if I don't find what I'm looking for? In other words, I don't have something that I need to bring over to my freeform table. Well, on three of these types over here, namely metrics, segments, and date ranges, if I put that in there like that, you'll see that I have a plus sign for create date range, create segment, and create metric up here. So you don't really create dimensions in the interface like this, but you can create a calculated metric, you can create a new segment, or a new date range. And if you're in here, you know, clicking on the plus sign might just be the easiest. You do also have a menu option under components, and you can create the new segment, metric, or date range. You can also create a new alert right here as well. Or you can use, of course, the quick keys over here. As you can see, for example, new segment is Shift Command E. So if I do that and I go Shift Command E, this is going to give me the segment builder. Let's do a quick one. Let's just say home page visitors. So that means I'm going to change this to a visitor, and I'm going to say where the page equals home, and I'm going to save that. Now, when I save that, you can see that it has come to the top of the list over here. I have home page visitors, and so I can now quickly find that and drag that into my reports and use it to filter my data down to just the homepage visitors. In any case, that is really kind of the create, right? I've been able to find things by searching or navigating, and then I've been able to create segments, or again, you can do the same thing with creating a new calculated metric or creating a new date range. And we'll go deeper into those other ones, including the creating new segments, in other videos. I just wanted to show you that you can do this over here as you are using this left rail to build up stuff in your freeform table. Now, the last thing I said was being able to add things from the left rail. And really, that's where you do a lot of your adding, is from this left rail. You're looking for stuff, you find it or you create it, and then you add it to your freeform tables. So I already showed you how you can add a product. You can also add metrics, of course, by dragging those over. I can also multi-select. So I'll grab, let's say I want visitors and unique visitors. You can see I can multi-select here, and I can drag those over, and I can add those to my report. Super easy. I can do the same thing for segments. In fact, I can add segments. I can add multiple segments. Let me go like this and grab these two and just drag those in here. And I can add those or filter those columns by these segments. And I'll grab that. And that gives me, of course, the visits by either homepage visitors or mobile customers, etc. So in any case, this is how you add things. Again, you can add them one at a time from the left rail. You can multi-select and add those to your table as well. And you can even multi-select in your table and add one thing over to both of those. So I can filter those. And now we can see that I have filtered my unique visitors and occurrences by tablet customers. In another video, we'll get more into some of the things you can do inside the freeform table. In this video, I just wanted to show you all the different things that you can do from the left rail over here as far as finding the stuff you need, building new stuff if it's not there, and then dragging stuff into your report. Hope that was helpful. Good luck.